Well, hi everybody, it's good to be with you again. It's Jeff Hopper with Jeff Cranford, and we are talking about some of the themes that popped out at us from this year's magazine. And Jeff, through the years, and it's 16 years now that I've been, had the privilege of doing a magazine.
I didn't know you were that old, Jeff.
I know, I
16
am that old.
Years, crazy.
So, and the magazine's been around for 35, and it's, you know, Link's letter form and the magazine form. And so obviously through the years, there are stories that I just kind of remember and say, man, this was one of the great interviews and one of the great stories. And certainly the story of Mike Wan, the commissioner of the LPGA, was that for me this year. He just has a way of telling his story, and we were able to work well on putting his story to paper in a way that maybe it's never been there before. And the thing that jumped out at me as we had this conversation was the way that God set him up through the years to do exactly what he's doing right now.
Right, right.
And, you know, walked him through various corporations that he worked for, Procter & Gamble and a hockey corporation, Mission Hockey, and some of these things that he did through the years that you say, well, really, that set you up for the LPGA?
Right, right.
And yet, when it came, this offer to work with the LPGA, it was just a perfect fit.
Right.
And you refer to that sometimes as unintentional preparation.
Unintentional preparation.
What does that mean?
Well, I think back, and I think everybody will reflect back to their lives, and they'll think, wow, how did I get to where I am now? It's a series of events. And of course, as a Jesus follower and a believer in God and His sovereignty, you look back and go, well, why did I ever get introduced to golf in the first place? Why was I attracted to it? Why was I born in the 20th century? Why not the 16th century?
Yeah.
Or why am I here now? Acts 17 talks a little bit about that. God put everybody in a particular place at a particular time, an appointed time. And then you look at the series of events that you got. Why did I go to Rice University? Why did I play golf in college? Well, you know, all these different things. And yet we see the same thing in the biblical narrative. The Apostle Paul had his Roman citizenship. He was trained, knew everything. Trained under Gamaliel in terms of his ability to understand the Old Testament and all the prophets, even though he didn't see them in light of the Christ event until his experience on the road to Damascus, there was an event in his life. And I think sometimes that's what happens to us. All of a sudden we hit an event and we look back and we see, oh my gosh, God has been preparing me for this moment, and I was completely unaware of his preparation. From my vantage point, it was unintentional. From his vantage point, it was very intentional.
Absolutely.
Every sickness that you go through,
yeah.
Every struggle that you have, even failures, deep failures that you have maybe in your life. Many of you say, well, God, you stand off from God because you have the failures in your life, and you don't recognize, wait a minute, God's going to use successes, failures, and everything. God is a shrewd God. He doesn't waste any experience in your life moving you towards his calling in your life. And that unintentional preparation is one of the deep spiritual truths that has buoyed my faith for so many years.
Let me put you one other place with this conversation. In Ecclesiastes 3:14, we read, I know that everything God does will remain forever. So it's not just like, okay, he's set you up for right now. He set you up for an amazing, grand purpose.
And the eternality of that and the full context of that is so powerful. When I think about links, we think about, wow, these are eternal matters.
Mm-hmm.
These are matters of such great significance. We're talking about an eternal soul. And when God is acting, He's thinking with eternity in mind. We think it's a little bit what we talked about in that first article with Ben. We think so temporally. We have the tendency to, you know, and we say, hey, you got to delay gratification to our kids, you know, save up for that car. And those are true. But we need to save, we need to even move it beyond this life. Have delayed gratification, the fullness of this life. Because when God's acting, He's thinking, as we may see next week, with generations to come in mind.
That's big stuff to think about, and I hope that it has been kind of something that has sparked your thought about where God has taken you and why He's put you there.